This Obamacare thing, they claim, oh, it's as good as any Silicon Valley company could make it. It's all going to be just wonderful. You know, I read something that said, if you like conspiracies, that this whole thing is set up to fail.
Yeah.
I mean, the whole...
I've heard the same thing.
You've heard the same? Mm-hmm. That it's set up to fail so that when it fails, Congress will say, well, we've got a solution. The government's going to run it all.
Our government. Isn't that great?
And it'll be single payer. You don't have to worry about a thing. We're not going to bother about all those insurance companies that are charging you all these terrible fees. We're going to have single payer. Could it be a possibility? Let's hope not. Well, the launch of that website was obviously a monumental disaster that caused a major public relations fiasco for the White House. And now, as I said earlier, the administration said things are looking better. But critics say the White House, surprise, surprise, is just playing politics.
Shocker. Plenty of questions still remain about just how well that site is working and about the problems with Obamacare itself. Ephraim Graham has the story.
The White House is hoping a more operational website will mark a fresh start for the president and his health care law. Round-the-clock repairs leading up to Saturday's deadline have resulted in some improvements.
I think that they can expect to have a lot less issues and errors with their user experience.
Still ahead of the deadline, government officials work to keep consumers' expectations low, proving just how delicate some of those repairs still are.
To be clear, November 30th does not represent a relaunch of healthcare.gov.
The White House even urged consumers to shop on the healthcare.gov website only during off-peak hours. Supporters of the president urge Americans to focus on the number of people who will soon have insurance, rather than problems that remain with the website.
I think the president can right this ship. This website is now apparently functional. Now, I haven't tried the website, but if this program works, and I think it will, 3 months from now, a huge number of people who didn't have health insurance are going to have it, and mostly at a better price.
But Republicans say while people may now be able to actually log on, significant problems remain.
I talked to some people in the insurance industry this morning, and they told me that most of the front end may be looking good. People may be able to get on and get responses. But the information coming out the back end to the insurance companies is still garbage.
Other critics say the real problem doesn't lie in a broken website, but in a flawed law.
And unfortunately, as people enroll, I think there's going to be a lot of negative surprises as to what they're able to enroll in.
Ephraim Graham, CBN News.
Well, the whole system works on having young people pay for the sickness of the old people. And the young people are saying, no way. It's better to pay a fine than to double or triple the amount we're paying for insurance for stuff we don't need. We don't need maternal health care and stuff like that. We don't need it. And certainly men at 65 don't need maternal health care either. So there are bells and whistles that are being forced on people that they don't want. Instead of saying, okay, I want to get coverage for this, and I'll pay this big a deductible in order to get a low rate, and that's the market. But the socialists who run the system don't like the market. So that's the way it is. Well, the world of Christian television has suffered a loss with one of the pioneers who has passed away over the weekend, and John Jessup has that story from Washington.
Pat, Trinity Broadcasting Network co-founder Dr. Paul Crouch died Saturday. He'd battled with heart problems over the last 10 years. Charlene Israel has this look at Crouch's legacy and the reaction to his passing.
All over the country, they're coming to know Jesus. Church, I think we ought to rejoice because the whole world is getting saved. Hallelujah!
Crouch and wife Jan founded TBN in 1973. It eventually became the world's largest Christian television network. Fellow ministers joined others on TBN's social media pouring out tributes. Famed cross carrier Arthur Blessed wrote, "Tears pour from my eyes. I'll miss my friend, but there is a joy in heaven where millions of people are thanking him for sharing Jesus with them." John Hagee, founder of San Antonio's Cornerstone Church, posted, Paul Crouch changed the course of Christian history by building a Christian network that spreads the gospel of Jesus Christ to the nations of the world every day. Crouch passed away at 2:32 a.m. Saturday, according to TBN, losing a long battle with chronic heart problems. He was hospitalized in October, but soon returned to work. He broadcast from various locations around the world in recent weeks. But he might have known his time was short. Here's what he had to say to his son Matthew last month in London.
My son, your wilderness is just beginning in a way. I'll be heading on home to glory before long. God bless you, but I can tell you, son, the same God that provided for Jan and me and all of this TBN family will provide for you.
Crouch and his family celebrated TBN's 40th anniversary this year with 84 satellite channels with more than 18,000 TV affiliates. But in recent days, the 79-year-old TBN founder had been speaking of his final journey and destination.
Just think, from Jesus' own lips,
well done.
Well done, good and faithful servants. Enter into the joys of thy Lord.
Pat, of course, our heartfelt condolences to the Crouch and entire TBN family.
Paul was a dear friend of mine. Every time I was with him, there was a real bond. We've known each other for decades. And I have been amazed at the growth of TBN, the indomitable spirit of Paul Crouch. He just kept going on. And I tell you, the station after station overseas, satellites and all the rest of it, it's been really very remarkable. And we share with many the mourning of the passing of our brother, but he's at a better place. He's with the Lord, and as he was saying, the Lord will say, well done, good and faithful servant. John?
Pat, the United States is urging North Korea to release two detained Americans. 85-year-old Merrill Newman has been in the country for more than a month, and Korean-American missionary Kenneth Bae has been detained for over a year. North Korea sees missionary work as a Western threat to its government. Bae's family said over the weekend they're praying for Merrill Newman as well. Newman was shown on North Korean state media reading an apology for alleged crimes during the Korean War and for hostile acts against the state during a recent trip. Well, here at home, Americans celebrated Thanksgiving weekend not only with turkey, but with shopping. Holiday shopping in the stores was down slightly, but online sales were up. Today is Cyber Monday, which marks the largest day for online buying. Forecasters expect a record day for sales. And speaking of buying online, Amazon.com is testing the possibility of using drones to deliver packages to your home. Amazon founder Jeff Bezos tells 60 Minutes the idea is to get those items shipped and delivered in 30 minutes or less. Pat?
I am astounded at Bezos. You talk about he just won't quit. Imagine a satellite, and it's got the GPS coordinates of your home. So you order something from Amazon, and suddenly this little bot appears in the sky and drops a package in front of your door and then zooms off for another day. It's absolutely extraordinary, but they're doing it. He started out selling books. And he said, you know, what's the deal? All right, I'm selling books. Now he's selling everything that people could want. It's simply amazing. But Terry, you know, I don't think the retailers are all that happy. A lot of people showed up for the, you know, Black Friday. The idea that this is the day they get into the black from their business. The number of people was up, but the amount per purchaser was down. These were very targeted shoppers. They wanted a TV that they could get for $120. Once they couldn't get that, then they left, went someplace else. And we'll see. But I mean, it's billions and billions of dollars. It isn't exactly a disaster, but it's not a ebullient time because people are hurting. There isn't that much money in people's pocketbooks. So today is Cyber Monday. And so many people are buying online. You never.
Well, it's much easier, isn't it?
Oh, yes. Mm-hmm. You just go boom, 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 and it's done. But, you know, in Virginia, somebody got shot. There were people who were being knifed, tasered. It was just outrageous, the stuff that went on.
Yeah, it really was. I think part of it is there are such deals offered out there, that people are camping out the night before. And it's, it really has become a tradition for a lot of people. I shy away from all of that.
Oh, I'm not the drive you crazy, not to mention disease. All right. John, what's next?
Pat, it's a form of modern-day slavery, and its victims come from every social and economic background and race. Now one man has made it his mission to make sure more and more people know that it's happening right here in the United States. Caitlin Burke has the story.
Human trafficking is one of the most heinous crimes in the U.S. today. Its growth is staggering, and most Americans don't even know it could be going on right in their own hometown.
It's not something that's coming from Thailand or Cambodia or anywhere else. It's a significant problem here in our own country.
Andrew Wallace admits he too had no idea of that reality until one day he read an article.
It was about a girl who'd had a dream to be a model, and she was instead tricked into thinking she was going to be a model and then sucked into the trafficking world. And that, I just had some anger inside.
Enlisting the help of his brother, Matthew Wallace, and longtime friend Jesse Cummins, the trio set out to fight this evil. Their mission? Winning love for the unloved.
The guys say they wanted to create conversation about trafficking. And what better way to do that than riding across the country on bikes?
Bikes generate curiosity, you know? And it also establishes at least a small amount of credibility with people. They're like, what? You went how far? And, oh, you're doing it for human trafficking? And
you must really care.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You must really care about this. And so it creates a platform.
They started at the most northwestern point of the country and pedaled 4,997 miles to Virginia Beach, Virginia. We met up with them as they celebrated the end of their journey. Along the way, they stopped to speak with anti-trafficking organizations, and in some cases, victims.
What I've learned is slavery is a community issue, and it's an issue that's uniquely poised to be solved by Christians, because it's hard to fight darkness with darkness, and we carry the light.
They shared their vision with the co-founders of the Virginia Beach Justice Initiative.
They reached across the nation and were reaching all kinds of people. They're younger guys. Having three young guys stand up for this cause is really wonderful. Having men in this cause is wonderful.
I really do feel like he's raising up his people in this hour to hear the cry, effectively the people in Israel. And he's saying, will you be that Moses for me to go into that venue I call you to help bring them out?
Andrew, Jesse, and Matthew are producing a documentary of their journey, one they hope will open eyes and hearts to human trafficking.
Hopefully to inspire individuals to say, yeah, this is a huge problem, and 27 million people in slavery is really ridiculous and dark, but if I stand up and do just the smallest thing, it can end.
Caitlin Burke, CBN News, Virginia Beach, Virginia.
Well, prayer can boost your self-control and emotional stability. The London Daily Mail reports that's the finding from a new study in Germany. Now, earlier studies found that when people simply tried hard to control their own emotions and thoughts, they tended to get angry or go into binge drinking or eating. But the German study says prayer gives people greater strength to maintain their self-control and ability to resist temptation. Other studies have also found prayer helps people control themselves, including decreasing the levels of adultery and drinking. Pat, I think that's a great study and all, but we as believers know that prayer can do much more than help self-control and our self-esteem.
Right. This is not a self-help program, you know. This is a talking to God, which is bringing into you, into your world, His world, and the power thereof. Mm-hmm.
Great
Be
study.
Careful for nothing, the Apostle Paul said, by everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God. And the peace of God, which passes understanding, will keep your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. That's what the Bible says, and it is true. It didn't take a study from Harvard or London or wherever else to validate that.
It's been true for people for centuries.
Amen. All right.
Voters in Croatia overwhelmingly approved a measure to define marriage as a union of a man and a woman. Nearly two-thirds of the voters supported amending the Constitution, which banned same-sex marriage. A Catholic group gathered nearly three-quarters of a million signatures to support the referendum, and that prompted Parliament to call for the vote. CBN helped to plan a three-night Franklin Graham Crusade in Thailand. Over 70,000 people from across the northern province attended, many riding in on the back of pickup trucks. Three hosts of CBN's local program, From Heart to Heart, emceed the event. and each night a CBN-produced testimony was shown on the big screen. CBN staff also served as volunteer counselors as thousands responded to the invitation to accept Christ. You can find out more about what CBN is doing around the world by logging on to cbn.com/international.